So, let's talk about PLL theory. That's an O, PLL theory. And so let's just draw this data flow diagram of our PLL again here. So we've got our input, and that's our cosine omega 0 t. But now I'm adding a unknown phase phi to it. Yeah, so that's here. Unknown phase. So in this case, we just assume we know the frequency of the carrier, but we don't know the phase. So we, at the end, we're going to do phase demodulation. So we're interested in the phase. And then we've got our low pass filter here. And then the low pass filter drives our VCO. The VCO, as we know, has two outputs when we think of our quadratic algorithm. So the one is 2 cosine of omega 0 t plus theta 0. So that's the unknown phase. That's the unknown phase of the VCO, because also we don't know that. And the 2 is here just for convenience. And so then the other output here of the VCO is 2 sine of omega 0 t plus theta 0. And what I'm doing here is I'm adding now a negative sign here. That's important to get the PLL working. And so this signal now goes back to our multiplier here. And so now the question is obviously why are we feeding the sine back here and not the cosine? So the cosine is just for our use here, and the cosine signal will be this cosine which is coming in here, which is sent in here if the PLL is in log. And so the interesting question is, so why do we do that? So why the sine? And the answer is, of course, because sine and cosine are orthogonal. That's an E. Yeah, so we directly see in the log condition when this signal here, when this cosine and this sine wave coming in here through this pathway, if they are exactly the same phase, so if psi and phi are the same phase, then this output here will be zero. And so then therefore the output will be identical here. So I'm going to derive this now a bit more mathematically. So how does it work? If we move this here a bit higher, just to have a bit more space on our recording, and we've got still here the circuit diagram here. So let's have a look. How does it look like at this point here? Yeah, so if we look at this point here. So we are multiplying the cosine with this minus sine here. Yeah, so then we have minus cosine omega 0 t plus psi, and we're multiplying this with sine of omega 0 t plus theta 0. And of course we've got the factor 2 here. So there's this convenient formula where we can just turn this into a sum and then into a difference. So therefore this then turns into minus square brackets sine of 2 omega 0 t plus psi plus theta 0. this gives us a term with two times the frequency, and then we've got the sign here with the difference between these two, so the omega zero cancels out, and what is left is theta zero minus psi. And so this one here, that's our phase difference between the input phase here and the output phase, and let's call this here minus delta phi. So phi is our phase difference between the input and the output. Between input and output, or essentially, or let's call this here the VCO frequency. So that's a difference here. And so if we're looking at this here, so then we can summarize this here. So that at this point here, we have here the a two-time omega zero frequency term here and just the phase difference. So this means that at this point here, if we're doing a low pass filtering, after low pass filtering, then we are just getting out there our sine of delta psi. Yeah, so this term here will then show up here. So this means here at this point here at this after low pass filter, the phase difference between the input signal and the VCO frequency drives the VCO.